Right, I think this is it. We are now recording. And okay. Here we go. So, 2020 Meltdown featuring Martin. And we've got TikTok ban in Norway, the social dilemma, bans and tech affiliation to BLM. Political marketing in music. And we're going to start with a little bit of a warning. Oh dear, that didn't go down to plan.
Whoops.
So, yeah, it's coming. Warning! This video contains sensitive information about a crime. If you are affected by this, please call your doctor and ask for mental health support or ring a helpline. If you are not affected by this, then write a letter to a representative in parliament or Stortinget. I just thought, you know, we might,
Go radical, right?
Yeah, we have to have an epic build up, mate. Epic. So, as we were, right, we were going to discuss TikTok, right? How much do you know about the TikTok situation?
You know, like, not so much, but I think I know what you want to talk about. And so, basically, some information suggests that the Chinese government is using TikTok as like some sort of information gathering app, right? Because it apparently does monitor quite a lot of metadata on several devices. And the stuff that I suppose we're going to talk about is why it's still allowed in Norway when in the US they are sort of banning it, or like they already did. I don't know. Was that the thing you wanted to talk about?
This is going to surprise you, because for the main reason, the storyline gets a little bit twisted.
No, go ahead.
It includes all tech. So I'm going to tell you the story about Ronnie McNutt. It's a tragic story of a man who killed himself on Facebook live stream. The Iraq veteran and Toyota worker Ronnie McNutt shot himself during a Facebook live stream as his family and friends watched in horror and police were outside his home. And the video has left young TikTok users traumatized. And it wasn't unusual for Ronnie McNutt to start a live stream on Facebook and ramble or argue with his audience about everything from theology to pop culture. And viewers knew what to expect with a church auto worker. So when he began his live broadcast on the night of the 31st of August, it was clear that something wasn't right. About 40 minutes into the stream, he was depressed, incredibly drunk. 33-year-old veteran picked up a rifle which misfired, sparking frantic calls to family and friends. As police stood outside his home, Mr. McNutt ignored calls and pleas from loved ones who watched in horror as he took his life, and they're now being confronted by that extremely distressing moment again as the video of death is shared on social media and viewed by young children. No, but pal, it doesn't stop there with this. I mean, I really did think the same as you. I thought, yeah, this conspiracy is getting a little bit thicker, and it's a plot, you know, and that we need to boycott China, but it got twisted. And the only reason why I feel that this is important is because, you know, this is an article in Norway. So it's Advaren mot selvmords video på TikTok. Helsesøster advarer foreldre barn ned mot 10 års alderen har sett selvmordsvideoen der en mann tar livet sitt på brutalt vis. And it's really shocking, really. I mean, I thought, well, why is it on TikTok if it was on Facebook? That was my first question.
And yeah, then, that's the part I don't understand either.
I know, right? How comes we've got the ability to share all this stuff on all platforms? I really don't know. Then it says, I kveld ble jeg kontakt av en ung voksen som hadde scrollet på videoer av hunder og valper på appen TikTok, hvor det plutselig dukket opp en video av en mann som tar selvmord, skriver helsesøsteren på Facebook-siden og legger til person som fortalte meg dette har nå kastet opp I flere timer etter å ha sett videoen. So it must have been pretty gory, you know?
Well, I don't know. Like, it doesn't have to be that gory. I've seen some footages of, you know, like some... I remember the first time I saw something really shocking was a guy climbed up to one of the bridges in Budapest and he set himself on fire and then he jumped off. Now, like I didn't see the very last part, him hitting the asphalt, but like, you know, like on the footage it's audible, the crash and everything, and it was a fucking shocking video, you know, like I even though like I have, it wasn't all that graphic, still. Mm. So I don't think it has to be like all that gory to be really disturbing for anybody. Like, I don't know, like, have you ever seen any videos where people die?
I mean, there's a lot of horror films and there's all kinds of things.
But horror films is nothing. I mean, you know, like, I've seen plenty of horror films, you know, like, on-screen death is nothing new to me, but like real death. Well, that's really something. And that, there's one other video that really, really struck me. Is like, it's from China, where apparently there's like a woman is trying to go through the pedestrian crossing, and then he's hit by a car. And then, like, you know, like all the pedestrians, they just walk by, nobody's helping, and then like, you know, of course, the light turns red and the cars come again, and they just keep driving over and over on this woman. Nobody's attempting to help.
That's scary.
It's fucking brutal.
Yeah, I never even thought that such things existed.
Yes,
because I've got an innocent mind.
I wish I could unsee this, but I did see it, and yeah. So like, you know, like this wasn't yesterday either. And this, the first one about the guy jumping off the bridge, it was, what kind of was it? Like about 10 years ago, 10, 11 years ago maybe. And I still like, I remember it really vividly, you know? So yeah, so the thing is that if you see death, like real death, then it leaves a mark.
I agree with you. I was thinking the same thing about how young people, they're pretty much sensitive, and we've desensitized them. We've made them think that everything is all right and they have to be big adults. Because I don't know, I'm going to tell you the honest truth. Yeah. You know when everybody was watching reality TV, like the Kardashians and that?
Yeah.
And Love Island and X on the Beach?
Uh-huh.
I'm the only one who hasn't watched it, because I think to myself, smart people don't need to see reality TV, because smart people don't care about that. They just want to get on with their lives, but they don't really say to themselves, my life is fantastic, so I want to look at something plastic. That's not what smart people do. But when you've told me about a death, okay, what springs to mind is just like, that's warfare, you know? And even though we've had a lot of desensitization, a lot of like things being seen, I'm actually shocked at Facebook, right? Which, you know, I don't want to go into that too deeply because that's the next topic. But I just want to like make sure that I was reading things right, because in Norway, there's no TikTok ban and there's no ban of tech that hasn't got ethics behind it. And it really worries me, right? Because I'm thinking, no, what was it? I saw an article. I'm going to show you the article. Hold on. Here we go. I'm going to show you the article. It says, en article, advare foreldre, TikTok gir Kina information om at norsk barne ikke kan danse. And it's supposed to be a joke.
Yeah, it's a satiric. So it's a satire.
But I'm not laughing, though, because of what happened to Ronnie McNutton. How the hell did that end up on the algorithm of TikTok so high, even for Norway? What's it got to do with Norway? That's what I want to know. I mean... Anarchu wants to do us all a favor and tell us that it's not important, but really, if Norwegian kids can't dance,
so Anarchu is making fun of this whole concern about TikTok leaking information to China. Is that it?
Absolutely.
Do I understand this correctly?
Absolutely. Well,
I think it's not the right approach. I mean, it's not, I don't think it's the content that's the most relevant to whoever can access the information. It's, I suppose it's a bunch of metadata, like, you know, like where it was recorded, when it was recorded and all that shit. Mm-hmm. And like, this doesn't seem to be like all that... all that interesting. It's just a bunch of numbers, and maybe it's not interesting at all, but well, the thing is that these things can be really, really useful when the most trivial use is doing forensics and investigations and stuff like that. So for example, preventing terrorist attacks. Like, these things can come in handy, like, you know, like, when was intense communication between this and that guy, you know, like, even though they can't see the communication, they can see when and where it happened, and then they can, deduct what's going on. And mm-hmm. I think that, like, China could, use this, such information in a similar manner, like, I don't know how, but, you know, like, then... there is no limit to what they can deduct from it, pretty much.
Well, so. I was thinking, you know, that's great that Tekniska Bladet had written about the situation, but at the same time, aren't they supposed to be informing us that there's this crazy stuff going on? And wouldn't parents like it if they didn't have to go to a mental health hospital for their kids all the time? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Kids are going mental.
Yeah. I mean, we're just driving each other mental right now, you know, with this virus, you know? And I say the word virus because every time that people mentions the C name, then everybody goes, oh no, we don't want to mention that because then that will mean that we have to use masks. which, you know, has led us down a very deep, dark path. But at the same time, we've got so much distraction going on. What's a band going to do? It's not going to hurt anybody, but there's still going to be, you know, there's still going to be people who commit suicide, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. And that's still going to happen around the world. Tech doesn't make any difference for that. But what makes a difference is the fact that people are left with a scar. So it's not like they're blaming every bloody metalhead for the problems of the world now. They're blaming TikTok, which is great. Yes, all lives on TikTok. That's
great. Yeah, okay, so you're saying that like this whole death blaming everything on metal and all that shit, like in 2020 it finally shifted from the metal bands to TikTok.
Absolutely. It's like
okay, that's actually a fun observation, but yeah, like,
couldn't you imagine the amount of parents who want to save their children? And
yeah, it's not going to be Marilyn Manson now or something.
You're damn right it's going to be Marilyn Manson, or it's going to be Green Day or something, you know what I mean? Start them off light. It's like, yeah, start them off from the very beginnings. And then it will be something, you know, very good. So hopefully we're going to see like loads and loads of bands from this that change. But I was thinking that tech was going to do kids a favor. But now kids are like getting blamed for every single thing going on. And their parents don't even have to have responsibility. You know, if you end up with a bad parent, what are you going to do, man? Which brings me to my next bit about this TikTok thing. I mean, yeah, they get, it says barn kan förbättras för att dela naken bilder. And it says in Norge är kriminal lava äldre. 15 år. Vad är straffen för att dela ett naken bilde utan samtycke? I mean, they are gonna get a 12,000, you know, krone bot, or a 5,000 krone bot, you know. Huh? And I'm just thinking, even though they would have to like do all of this stuff, it didn't have to happen. All we have to do is just ban the damn TikTok, right? And then it will get them to behave themselves, right?
No, don't you think? That's simple.
It's never that simple, is it?
It's never that simple because, you know, like, okay, people do fucked up things being drunk, right? But you don't ban alcohol straight away.
Good point.
So,
but we got a cannabis prohibition. Got to think about that. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, for the time being, yeah. But now it's like in Norway, it's already decriminalized. So, so if you're
caught, decriminalizing it, since when?
Yeah. I think it happened like 2 years ago or something. So it's, you know, like if you were caught with marijuana, they're not gonna arrest you. They're like sending you to rehab or something. So it's they're easing up on these rules, as far as I know.
Well, that saves a whole load of band members then, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's still not okay. So, but, you know, like the penalty is not very harsh, at least. So that's something.
So now we come.